नमस्ते, आदाब, सत श्री अकाल, केम टू डियर स्टूडेंट्स। सो हेयर आई एम बैक इन द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ दिस वीडियो ऑफ कीपिंग क्वाइट। सो ऑफ कोर्स यू हैव टू कीप क्वाइट टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस पोएम बेटर। सो बिफोर वी इनिशिएट द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ दिस पोएम एंड दैट इज फाइनल पार्ट, लेट्स हैव अ ब्रीफ रिविजन ऑफ फर्स्ट पार्ट। सो इन फर्स्ट पार्ट वी हैड स्टडीड that how Pablo Neruda advocates a unique concept before the world, and that concept is introspection, inactivity, contemplation, pondering over. You know, he in fact asks everyone to be quiet for a while, and by being quiet, you know, everyone needs to spend some time in contemplation, and after doing contemplation the world will realize how this process of contemplation can bring a sea change in the world. It will end all the discriminatory practices. It will establish the kingdom of universal brotherhood. It will realize the people how they have so far harmed flora and fauna in the name of their own need. And of course, it will give sufficient time to the people to think about their own follies. There are people who are suffering with self-inflicted injuries, they will have time to think about it. So in this way, the session of introspection will be very useful. I have missed one more point. And of course, this session will make them realize, the scientists, the politicians, how they are moving on the path of destruction and giving universal havoc. Most probably, you know, with their tendency of winning the world, they might get the same. But overall, no one will last to celebrate this victorious achievement of theirs. So this is what we had studied in second video, first video, and today we would go ahead. So let's see, what does the poem speak further? Pablo Neruda says, "What I want should not be confused with total inactivity." Now, right from the beginning, Pablo Neruda has been advocating inactivity, you know, ceasefire, what is tranquility, introspection. So it looks to him this persistent request of inactivity might make people confused about his intention. His plea, his advocacy of being inactive might be taken otherwise by the people. They might take him as a permanent supporter of inactivity. So here he clears his stand. What he says, what I want should not be confused with total inactivity. He says that my request of being inactive must not be taken otherwise. What he says, that if I am asking you to be inactive, I must not be taken otherwise, because I am not a permanent supporter of inactivity, motionlessness. Because what he wants inactivity for short time, for time being, because he himself knows, you know, the value of always ever ongoing process. So that is why he is saying that his advice of being inactive for a while must not be taken otherwise. People should not be confused. He is clearing his stand that he is not at all a supporter of permanent, what, stand still, permanent pause. Why? Because he himself knows the very vital, the most significant point of the life. Life is, what is it about? And what is life all about? Life is all about ongoing. So he himself knows life is, what is it about? And a student, what is life all about? Life is all about ongoing. So he knows very well that life is ongoing process. Chalti ka naam hi gaadi hai. And of course, this gaadi can never be stopped. Life can never be stopped. So that is why he himself knows this universal fact. And that is why he does not intend to hamper, to stop this wheel of life. I want no truck with death. And that is why he says he does not have any intention to stop life for a while. He does not want to connect life with death. What is death? अ सिंबल ऑफ परमानेंट हॉल्ट, परमानेंट पॉज, स्टैंड स्टिल. ही डज नॉट हैव एनी इंटेंशन टू कनेक्ट लाइफ विद डेथ. ही डज नॉट वॉन्ट इट, यू नो, टू कनेक्ट, टू लिंक विद डेथ. एंड दैट इज वाई ही मस्ट नॉट बी टेकन एज अ परमानेंट सपोर्टर ऑफ डेथ, बिकॉज ही नो लाइफ इज द नेम ऑफ ऑन गोइंग प्रोसेस and that what he believes in. So now let's see the next paragraph, student. So what is mentioned there? If we were not so much single-minded about keeping our lives moving and for once could do nothing, perhaps a huge silence might interrupt this sadness of never understanding ourselves and of threatening ourselves with death. So now let's understand what does the poet intend. So he says, if we were not so much single-minded. So first of all, student, what we are single-minded about? We are single-minded about only one thing, and that is our own materialistic benefits, worldly needs. We have gone mad behind materialistic benefits, you know. We work day in, day out to get them. And that what we have completely been focused about. Our aim is to have big cars, big bungalows, so many servants attending us. So because of all these dreams, we have dedicated our life. We never think about something else. So that's what the poet says, if we had not made this single object of a life about keeping our lives moving. So the poet is saying we are moving our life only for this aim. What the single aim? And what is that single aim? Materialistic, worldly benefit, worldly advancement. And for once could do nothing. The poet said, and for a while we stop doing anything. If for time being we cease all our works, so perhaps a huge silence. So silence, but you know, silence of not doing anything. But at the same time, you must remember, when we are not doing anything, we are doing something. And what we are doing introspection. So that's what the poet mentions here. That by not doing anything, and in fact by not doing anything, what we are doing introspection, the silence of introspection, perhaps a huge silence. Which silence? Silence which would be prevailed in whole world by not doing anything and by doing introspection. So the silence of introspection might interrupt this sadness. So this silence of introspection might disturb the sadness. Which sadness? Sadness of never understanding ourselves. Which sadness we are going from? The sadness of unable to understand ourselves. You know, there is a sadness in a life. We ourselves do not know what is the actual aim of our life. What we are living for? What do we want in actual? So that is why if we do introspection, so this silence of introspection will make us realize what is actual aim of life, what is the real ambition, why we are living for. See, in the name of materialistic benefits, we have allowed ourselves to indulge in a never-ending rat race of so-called advancement. Student, why I'm calling this so-called advancement? Because what is the real definition of advancement? Advancement is as such which advances us mentally, physically, spiritually, and of course economically. But in today's context, there is only one definition of advancement, and that is monetary advancement, economical advancement. You know, again, I am compelled to repeat the same. The biggest irony of a life has become that for the sake of comfort, we sacrifice our comfort. We work day in, day out, you know, having the ambition that money would earn peace for us, but then we don't have time to get peace. So the poet is saying the same. He is saying if we do introspection, we will realize the real aim of life. You know that this worldliness, this monetary gain, this so-called advancement is not at all our real aim. And what else we will realize? And of threatening ourselves with death. You know, we will realize that how in this mad rat race, we are threatening ourselves with death. How? See, we have become a part of cutthroat competition where we wish to be on the pinnacle of success, on the summit, on the top of the success by hook or by crook. For that, we are ready to give a real havoc to our opponent. We are threatening ourselves with death. You know, in this competition to be on the top, we are doing everything. And if, you know, we are unable to achieve our dream through fair means, we go for unfair. And the same applies on all these countries also. They are developing, you know, such destructive, lethal nuclear weapons. They are threatening others with death. So that's what we have been doing. You know, for us, success means everything. It must come to us anyway, and that is why we are challenging our life in the name of success. So now let's see the next lines. Perhaps the earth can teach us, as when everything seems dead and later proves to be alive. So once again, the poet is trying to support his old philosophy that he is not at all a supporter of permanent standstill. He knows life is the name of ever ongoing process. So that is why, you know, what he had told to be inactive for a while must not be taken by anyone otherwise. You know, and he knows that this ongoing process of the earth can be learned through Mother Earth also. That is why he says, perhaps the earth can teach us. As when everything seemed dead, later proved to be alive. When it looks that everything is finished, the life is stopped, that in fact becomes alive. So that what we can learn the same from Mother Earth. Mother Earth can of course teach us that on this earth never stop permanently. Mother Earth can teach us how life is always an ongoing process. See, perhaps the earth can teach us when everything seems dead, later proves to be alive. So Mother Earth teaches us it happens. Sometimes a thing seems to be dead, but later that thing becomes alive. Alright, how? Let's understand these lines through some example. How the ever ongoing process of the life can be understood. Let's move to prehistoric era. Now, which era is called prehistoric era? About which we don't have written documents. The era of dinosaur. Alright, there was a time when dinosaurs prevailed on entire earth. But later, what went wrong? You know, what natural calamity occurred? We do not know. But yes, that eradicated their existence to the fullest. You know, it looked at that time, the life got over. But once again, life rejuvenated itself. Life restarted. You know, once again, the seeds of life germinated themselves and the process of life continued. Another example of ongoing process of the earth can be understood through the cycle of season. Every year, there comes autumn season. It seems life is over in jungle. No zeal and zest, no enthusiasm at all is there in jungle. You know, everything seems to be dead. But later, this season is followed by spring season. So life makes itself live again. You know, so it proves that life never gets over. Even the formation of universe is a part of ever ongoing process of the earth. So that's what the poet says, the life never gets over. You must not confuse yourself with, you know, with the advocacy, with the request of permanent inactivity, that what the poet does not intend, and he in fact is teaching us through the example of art. So now let's see the very last two lines of this poem. Poet says, "Now I will count up to 12 and you keep quiet and I will go." So now the poet asks the listeners to count up to 12. You know why he is asking others to count up to 12? Because now he is willing to go to his session of introspection. And as we had studied in the beginning, what is his systematic way to commence this activity? That is to count up to 12, because in this way he is able to distract his attention from the ongoing happenings of the world. So that is why he asks everyone to count up to 12, to follow the same system. You keep quiet. Poet asks others to keep quiet. Why? Because they have to do their session of introspection. So they need to be quiet and I will go. He asks that you must do your introspection and let me do the same. And I'll go for what? For my own session of introspection, for realizing my follies, my blunders, my mistake. You know, so that's what he speaks. So eventually, what is the message of this poem, student? The poem gives us message that we must spend some time with ourselves, because spending time with ourselves will make us realize our mistakes. So every night when you go for sleeping, you must close your eyes and you must talk to yourself all night. Today I did this wrong. I punched my friend when he was studying very poor. I stole breakfast of my friend, very bad. And I fought with my enemy, very bad. So every day you must do these kind of practices. This will make you realize where you have gone wrong. And of course, stop the temptation of money. If you are unable to handle money, give it to me. I will take your problem. I am very helpful. And you must live your life happily. So thank you so much for listening to this video. You are great. And so am I.